Hey, this is Mikey with another After Effects tutorial. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to do this cool double exposure look as seen on the new HBO show, True Detective. Now make sure you go check out the actual titles from the TV show. There's a link in the description where you can go see them. Now I don't know if the way I'm doing it is the actual way that they did it for the titles. It's just what I had come up with. Now before I get into the tutorial, I just want to encourage you to subscribe to my channel. I put out new tutorials every Friday, and all throughout 2014, I've got lots of cool software and plugin giveaways I'm going to be doing, some big ones, and the tally right now is well over $1,000 worth of software I'm going to be giving out, so pretty darn cool. So let's get started. So let me just pause this, create a brand new composition. Now, I have these clips here. I've got four different video clips I'm going to be using for this. So there's the one that's the first one. The second one is of the trees. And then I have some dust and a lens flare. And what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to package all of these clips up together with a download so you can just go download them and test it out with this footage. I do must warn you, it's not the best footage. The colors was a little bit off on this green screen, but it will get the job done. So just follow the link in the description. There's also a download annotation right on the top of this video you can see right now, and just click on that and it'll take you right to where you can download this footage and try for yourself. Now what I want to do is I want to first set up this tree footage to work the way I want it to. So I'm going to take this, select it, and then pre-compose. So Command-Shift-C will bring up my pre-compose dialog box. I want to make sure I move all attributes. I'm going to call these trees. And it creates a new composition. Let's go into this new composition. Now, what makes the original look kind of have a nice 3D depth to it is there's some parallaxing going on with the trees. And this footage I have, it doesn't do that. So, in order to create that look, what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this top layer, go into the mode, set it to multiply, and let's just kind of move it to a different spot. And then let's take an effect, go to color correction, and just curves will do. And let's crank this up until you don't see a hard line. I'm also going to go into the blue and drop the blue a little bit. Try to make things kind of mesh together. Now what I want to do is first let's hide this top layer. Let's go to that bottom layer, and I want to scale this up. So I hit S on the keyboard, it brings up my scale. And I'm just going to move it so it's about right like this. And then let's turn this top layer back on again, and I'm going to really kind of distort this. I want to put it in a slightly different spot. Hit P on the keyboard, click on position, then go to the end. And I'm going to move it just a little bit. And maybe I'm going to take this top one and move it over here. So okay. Now another thing I can do is come in here. I'm going to, with the curves, go back to the RGB and maybe bring the, so the black is a little bit blacker. Okay. So that's basically all we're going to do with this composition. Let's go back into Comp 3. And so that's what it looks like. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to add an effect. Color correction, tint. And then effect, color correction, levels. And you can see right here, this is kind of ramping up. And then lots of this value here, and it's kind of cutting down. I want to grab this arrow and bring it over until it's about right there. Okay. Next, let's work on this other piece of film. Now, this guy's name is Aaron Alsop, and he's graciously donated his face in order for me to do this. He works in the office with me here, and he has a brand new filmmaking tutorial YouTube channel. Want to go check it out? Just click on the link here, or there's also a link in the description. Filmmaking Tutorials with Aaron Alsop. Very good channel, lots of great info and tips. check him out. He's just starting out, so he could use all the help he can get as far as subscribers and viewers. So just do me a favor and go check out his channel. That would be awesome. But what I'm going to do, let's go to the effects, and let's just key this out. I'm going to use key light, and it does a pretty good job. I'm going to go then to my screen mat, which gives me a black and white version of it. Then I'm going to come down here where it says screen mat, and let's clip the black and the white and get a nice solid key. Maybe even soften this up a little bit. Set this back to final results. And then the next thing I need to do is use my pen tool and just crop out the edges. Okay. Move the trees to the bottom. And then what I can do here is I'm going to turn on the trees. And then under track mat, I'm going to go to alpha mat. And that's the first step to getting this look. And what I do next now is let's take this Aaron, duplicate that. We can turn this back on. And I'm going to take this, add an effect, color correction, tint. And then effect, color correction, curves. And I'm going to really kind of crank this a little bit. I want to create a nice black and white gradient. And then after I've done this, I'm going to pre-compose this, so Command-Shift-C. I'm going to call this Aaron Gradient. And I can just hide this down below. I can even turn it off. So now on this trees layer, I'm going to go to Effect, Distort, Displacement Map. And for the Displacement Map layer, I'm going to use this Aaron Gradient. And what I can do is I can come in. So you can see here, it's looking like Aaron is displacing the footage. And I might want to just do a little bit more. Let's go 12 by 12. Maybe not that much. Okay, I think that's looking pretty good. So that's the first step. Now the next step after this is going to take this Aaron composition again, or this footage layer, duplicate it. Let's turn this on. Now what I want to do here is I'm going to go into the key light where it says final results, and I'm going to switch that to screen mat. And here I want to then go into screen mat, and let's crank the softness really soft, and maybe the shrink grow, bring it in a little bit. And then from here I'm going to pre-compose this, so Command-Shift-C, move all the attributes, and what this is going to be called is edge mask. Come back into this composition and let's create just a shape layer. So deselect any layers you have down here, grab your pen tool, and I'm going to make kind of a big upside down trapezoid type thing. And then let's go to effects, blur, fast blur, and blur that so it kind of matches with what's going on here. And I might have to go in and adjust the position, so I hit P on the keyboard, brings up a position. Let's go to the end of the composition and kind of move it so it'll kind of track along. That's about all I need for this look. Let's go back into the main composition, and then again let's duplicate the Aaron layer. Let's turn this on and let's come into now Luma Mat, but I need to do Luma Mat inverted. And what it's done is you can see there's the edge that you can still see kind of creeping in the edge. And if I want to adjust that, let's go back into the edge mask, click on the Aaron, and let's go in and lock this. There's a little lock icon right here, and we can lock that. Go back into Comp 3, and now let me come into the screen mat, and I can adjust the screen shrink and grow, the softness, and things like that to get it the way I want. And I like that. So let's come back onto this Aaron layer here. And then let me edge Aaron. And let's go to effect, color correction, and we want the hue saturation. And then effect, color correction, we want curves. So let's first bring down the saturation and let's increase the contrast. Maybe bring down the lightness. Okay. That's looking pretty good. Now let's add the background to this. So let's go to layer, new, solid. And let's pick kind of a brownish color. Click OK. Let's put this down at the bottom. And then what we can do from here is just click on this layer, the trees layer, and I'm going to click on the transfer mode. Let's go to multiply. And then what that does is it kind of brings this background color forward. So that's the main part of this look. Now to add some few little niceties at the end, also included is the dust that's in the download that you can download. And this is just some dust particles. And then again, let's go into this, go to add. There's also some lens flares. So as we can look through here, there's a nice little side lens flare. With this one, same thing. Let's go to add. And everything's going to kind of brighten up here a little bit. Okay, next, let's add an adjustment layer. And what I want to add to this is just a vignette. So if you haven't done so already, make sure you download my vignette preset. There's a link in the description. And it adds a nice little vignette. Maybe we can change the radius, the feather, add a little bit of darkness to it. Okay, and then one last thing I want to do before I add in the titles is I want to add kind of an edge blur. And the way I like to do this is with a brand new adjustment layer. We'll call this edge blur. I should be naming these the whole time. Vignette. Okay, let's go to the edge blur. Let's go to effect, blur and sharpen, camera lens blur. Okay, and then next we need to add a new solid. Doesn't matter the color. And then go to effect, generate, gradient ramp. And this is going to create a ramp, and I want to do a radial ramp. Let's grab the points and have it centered right in the middle. And a nice big kind of a radial gradient. And you want black on the in the middle on this one. Then let's go to effect, color correction, go to levels. And what I want to do here is I want to kind of crush the whites or the blacks to create more of a big black circle in the center that kind of gradients out. After I've done that, I'm going to need to pre-compose this. So blur map, that's good. I can just turn this off, throw it down at the bottom so it's not at the top. And then let's come into this camera lens blur. And for the blur map layer, go back to that blur map. And what it's done is it'll blur the edges but keep the inside nice and clean. I can adjust this. It's a little bit too much. Let's try 10, maybe 14. And that's kind of a nice, I like how it kind of blurs at the bottom there and a little bit on the edge. Let's add the title. This is really small. I'll crank it up here a little bit. So as far as the color, you're going to want something that's kind of in the same tone. So I just grab the eyedropper and let's pick one of these colors here. I also like to put this down near the bottom so that the blur kind of affects it as well. And then let's just go to the opacity. I'm going to keyframe it at 100% and I'll just move it over there. Bring this down to 0. And come here towards the end, bring it back down to 0. And it looks like I had the gain on the blur turned on, which didn't work when the lens flare came in. So I just turned that off. So let's take a look at it. I'm going to render this out and you can see what it looks like when we're done. Okay, so here it is, all finished up. Now, some other things I like to do to this is add a little bit of grain. You can might even do like a RGB split, so chromatic aberration or something to that effect to kind of add a little bit more distress looking to it. Now, I didn't do that because, again, this is taking a long time to render an effect like this with all these different layers and different transfer modes and blurs and things like that adds a lot of rendering time. This is only about 3.5 seconds. Took me a good couple, maybe 3 minutes to get through this whole RAM preview. So that's just a good example of how long this could take. So be prepared for rendering times with things like this. Certain things could cut that down, the displacement map, that we have right here to kind of create this little warp effect. That will cut it down if you don't want to do that. Also, the edge blur will cut it down if you take that out as well. So I hope you enjoy this. If you have any questions as far as how I put this together, if you've got different ideas of your own, feel free to put them down in the comments below. And make sure you grab this download pack, get the two video clips, and also the dust and the lens flare. It's all included in there. Grab it, download it, make your own version of this, and let's see what you can do. Again, thanks for watching. Be sure to check out my channel, subscribe, see all the different videos I'm putting out. Again, every Friday I put out a new video. And also, go check out Aaron Alsop's channel. The link is down in the description. They're always down in the description. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.